Hey guys, today we're going to be looking at the Oris and Hodinkee collaboration, Diver 65. So the instructions manual for this book was actually outside the box. And the interesting thing about this watch is that this is the first Diver 65, to my knowledge, which has the caliber 400 in it. So it comes in this nice compact gray box. Looks like a high quality paper. I think it's pretty nice. It's like a simplistic design. So you take this outer sleeve off. Got Oris and Hodinkee right there. Inside, it's wrapped in this cloth that says go your own way. Oh, that's cool. It has a map, looks like, of Switzerland in here on the inside of the cleaning cloth. Oh, it comes in this nice leather pouch. It's like a tan leather. Wow, that's really nice. Oris logo right in there. And really high quality wool inside here. That's a nice touch. You don't usually see that. And it looks like the warranty card holder. This is just leather, no wool inside, but still very nice. It gives everything kind of a more premium feel. There's a warranty card in there. It looks like you could fit something else in there too. You could even use this as a wallet if you really wanted to. And there's the watch, guys. Very nice. So the interesting thing about this watch is, besides that it's a Hodinkee collaboration limited to 400 pieces only, it is the first Diver 65 38mm with the caliber 400, as you can see right there. And the beauty of the caliber 400 is, as stated on the dial, it has a 5-day power reserve, which I think is amazing. And this is a 38mm diver's watch, which is kind of like the perfect vintage size. I love Oris because it's kind of like a low-key brand. It's not as big as some of the other Swiss manufacturers, but it's getting up there, and it doesn't really have much of a cult following like Seiko does, for example. And they haven't really been popular for that long. In the most recent years, they've been catching a lot of popularity, and a lot of their models had a lot of buzz going on them, like the Cotton Candy bronze divers, for example. This one just looks like such a nice, like, vintage homage. Oris has made divers back when manufacturers first started making divers as well. So they've been around for a while. As you can see on this hang tag, it says 1904. Not quite as old as Seiko, but still very nice. And you also get this awesome 10-year warranty tag on here. I mean, just look at that dome crystal. And it is sapphire, of course. Very nice, kind of understated Swiss luxury piece here. But at being at 38mm, it just fits that vintage bill so well. Even more so than the Tudor, I would say. Though 1mm won't really make too big of a difference. I just feel like on this watch and the way that it shapes, it just looks so elegant. And it looks like on the Hodinkee collab here, they chose to go with a dark forest green dial, which I think is an amazing color for this kind of watch. It just suits it so well. And under light, you could see it kind of takes a lighter shade of like forest green. It goes from a light shade of forest green to a very dark, almost gray color. And in certain angles, it even looks black. But it always has like that little bit of emerald just shining in there, which I think looks really nice. I've been a fan of the Oris divers for a long time. I always thought they had a very clean aesthetic to them. The handset, the dial, the markers, everything has always looked so traditional and kind of classy. Another cool thing about this is, unlike most divers, this one has a countdown bezel, which means that it starts at 60 and it goes down all the way. So the markers go from 50, 40 to 30 instead of 10, 20, 30. Etc. Really cool. And this one has 100 meters of water resistance. So it's not like your typical divers, which have at least 200. But I mean, let's be honest, 100 meters is pretty good for any watch. And it's still decent, especially for the type of watch this is. Especially for vintage watches, which were usually rated up to 150 for the higher spec. And that signed crown, really awesome. Really love that. And this bracelet, which has this beautiful taper. Bracelet looks really nice. Feels really solid too. Very solid, I would say. See that little bit of movement, but that's average. But very nice finished, brushed finish there. Polished on the sides. Nice little contrast of brushed and polished right there. It looks really nice. And that bezel just looks like a vintage bezel brought back. It is so cool. Clasp is pretty good. And there's that movement. Really cool. I've never seen a movement that looks like this. It's a very unique design. Wow, that is a very nice fitting watch right there. Very compact, definitely feels vintage, feels really nice. I love this about them. I've been wanting an Oris for a very long time, but I've just been waiting for that perfect one. And this one is, you know, I thought it was unique enough to get. It was going to stand out, be a little different from my other divers. I was tired of getting all the same kind of aesthetic, and I wanted something that was a little different, especially since I love divers so much. This is like perfect for me. And that beautiful box crystal, like that sapphire, just looks amazing. And I don't know if you can tell, but unlike my other watches, this one doesn't really have a contortion when you look at it from the side. Unlike my SLA and the Tudor and many other watches, even though this one has a much higher raised crystal, but they did something where even from the side, you can read it. It's very legible and you can read it perfectly. Everything feels very solid about this watch. And I think it's really cool. I mean, the fact that it comes in this leather pouch, everything feels very like vintage inspired and very like tool watch oriented. Just high quality for not too much. Really good bang for your buck. This one was more than their typical divers, but you do have to keep in mind it comes with the caliber 400 and it does have that awesome 10-year warranty as well. This one ran about 3,800. And it sold out, I want to say, within the first hour or so. And just amazing, guys. Compared to, like, my Seiko divers and the upper-end Swiss watches, I would say it does feel different than them. I'm not saying it feels different in a bad way. You notice that there is something different. Each watch has its own feel. Seikos kind of feel like Seikos. Omegas have their own kind of feel to them. Even the Tudor, they're all very different. It could be the type of steel they use, the machining, but it's still a very solid feeling watch. And this one just has a very vintage inspired theme to it. And I really like that. All right. So what do you guys think? Let me know in the comments below. All right. See you guys next time.